In this lecture we will continue the explanation of a transistor. In the previous lecture we explained what is transistor, what are the main configurations of transistor, and what are main, its main functionality. In this lecture we will explain what is the characteristic curve of a transistor. We will explain many configurations about الاكتف مود او الاكتف configuration. First of all, what is the characteristic curve? To explain the characteristic curve, we should explain the diode characteristic curve first. If we have a simple circuit like this, a resistor and a diode, and would like to apply KVL in this circuit, we will have minus V source, which is named here VDD minus VDD, بلس الفولت at this point اللي هو بلس الاي الاي دي multiplied by الار بلس الفي دي equal zero equal zero. الفي دي is الفي اوف الديود which is مثلا الفي كابت الدي كابت. طيب to draw the characteristic curve of the diode, we have to draw the relationship between the ID and the VD. Any element in this equation related to the diode, which is the I and the V. So we draw the relation. We draw the VD at the x axis and ID at the y axis. We have to test this circuit or this loop for many values of ال V of ال diode. If ال V if ال current is equals to zero, I the V و I. If ال current equal to zero, ال V D و ال I D. Since the V is in X axis, Y is in I is in Y axis. So this point is V and I. If we set L I to be zero in this equation, we will find in the V diode equals to L V D D. So this point will be equal V D D minus V D D and zero. And if we set L V D equal to zero in this equation, we will find in L I D equals to L V D D over R. Okay, mathematically, yeah. So L V zero. So this point will be zero. L zero we L V D D over R. If we make the intersection between these two characteristic curve, we will find that this is the operating point, or this is the point at which the diode will give a logical current in the circuit. This point is will be at 0.7 if the diode is in silicon. Okay, so this is the characteristic curve, the relation between the volt and the current in the diode in the forward case. Okay, we refer to this point as the operating point. This line is called the loading line, the load line, which connect between the two points at which L I equal to zero and get the value of L V, and L V equal to zero and get the value of L I. This is the load line. This is the diode response if we change L V of L V D many values. If we set in this equation ال V of ال V of ال V source to be مثلا say 10, 9, 3, 4, any values. So this will be the response of the diode at different values of ال V source. Okay. So the intersection between the diode response and the load line is the operating point at which the diode works properly and starts to work properly. This is the characteristic curve. With the same method, we would like to draw the relation, the characteristic curve of a transistor, but a transistor has two loops or has two يعني the transistor is two diodes. So we'll draw the characteristic curve two times. One for the input characteristic curve and one for the output characteristic curve. ال okay. ال output characteristic curve. The input characteristic curve, if we have مثلا a transistor in, like in this circuit, okay, we'll have a resistor here, say مثلا, and the voltage source, and a battery and a resistor. In this loop, we'll have a resistor and a voltage source. We say that this is the input loop, and this is the output loop. Since this is contain this is the input IE or current at the emitter, where this is the IC, which is the output. We have in B in and if we connect this to be negative forward and this to be reverse, so the negative will be rebel with the negative, so this all negatives will translate to this positions, and this will be the input current and this will be the output current. So the input current is in the emitter, the output current will be in the collector. Okay, طيب. So this loop is called the input loop, and this is the output loop since it has the IC. We would like to draw the characteristic curve of the input loop and draw the characteristic curve of the output loop. The input loop has a characteristic curve. We draw the relationship between all elements that appear in the KVL of this loop. If we would like to draw the apply KVL here, we will have مثلا الV source, وهير الR base, and this is RE. And to apply the KVL, we will have الV source, الI base, R base, وهنا الVBE, وهير we will have IE, RE. So we can draw the relationship between الVBE and ال I base. Okay, draw the relationship between the volt and the current of the diode at this A, at this equation that appear in this equation. طيب, this if we would like to set many values of the V source, we will have this characteristic curve, this characteristic curve of the VBE. Okay, which مثلا ال 1.2 is a practical value of the VBE to be in forward mode. Okay, طيب. For the output characteristic curve, we apply the KVL in this loop. We will find that our equation will have IC and VCE. To apply the KVL in this loop, we will have the V source plus IC RC and the VCE, difference between these two points, and the IE. In some equations, we don't have the IE. Okay, we may have resistor at the this branch. We'll have the IE without without RE. Okay, so we draw the relationship between the I base and the VBE, and in this equation we'll draw the relationship between the IC and the VCE. Okay, IC, so we'll have here the VCE and the IC. If we would like to understand this figure, we can notice that in we have in this equation IC and VCE. If we would like to substitute in this equation by different values of the I base, we will have this this line and this line and so on. But the main regions in this figure is that when IC equals to zero, when IC equals to zero, this means that in IC equals to zero, This means that in the i base equal to zero since i c equal beta i b. و ال i e equal to zero, which means that in the transistor in this case is in active mode. So the region of this figure, okay, this value is this values of any values of VCE that is negative and any values of IC to be negative. This means that in the transistor is in active mode, sorry, in cutoff mode. Type. For this region, we'd like to مثلا draw another مثلا line, another color. I hope يعني color مثلا أصفر. Okay. For this region of the characteristic curve, if we set the VCE to be any value less than the zero, and you say zero or any value less than 0.7, the transistor is set to be in saturation mode. Saturation mode. Okay. Any region بقى other than this region will be in active mode. This region is in active mode. Any region or any values of VCE or any values of IC will be in active mode. Okay, active mode. This cutoff. Any values of ال IC less than or equal zero. Okay. طيب why you said that in any values of the VCE less than 0.7 make the transistor to be in saturation mode. If I say that in ال VCB equal to ال VCE minus ال VBE, first of all, this is a rule. I would like to مثلا prove this relation first. طيب ال VCE right hand side, ال VCE, ال VCB means ال VC minus ال VB, VC minus ال VB. Okay, okay. ال VCE minus ال VBE equal ال VC minus ال VE. We would like to مثلا VCE means VC minus VE, so it will be VC minus ال VE. Then negative, so it will be negative, it will be negative minus ال VB plus ال VE. So ال VE will be removed with this VE, so it will be equal to ال VC minus ال VE, ال VC minus ال VB. Okay, so this equation is true. The question is, what if ال VC equals to zero? What if ال VC equals to zero? So ال VCB equals to minus VBE, minus VBE, which is minus 0.7. Okay, minus 0.7. What do I mean by in ال VCB equal to minus 0.7? This means that in VCB equal 0.7, this means that in ال VB is greater than ال VE. ال VB, ممكن we can remove this. معلش سوري. This means that in ال VC minus ال VB equals to zero. Equals to negative 0.7. This means that in ال VB is greater than ال VC. if ال VB is greater than ال VC, this means that in this junction is forward. Okay, as we said before in the active moment. So if ال VB is greater than ال VC, this means that this junction is forward, which means that in the transistor will be in active mode. So I will have I will have this junction to be forward. El VB is greater el VB will VC. I will have مثلا in كده this diode. So ال B in or ال base collector, this will be greater than ال VB will be greater than ال VC. Okay, ال base collector. So this junction will be forward. If this junction is forward, so it will be in active, it will be in saturation. Okay. So once LVCE equals to zero, this junction is said to be forward and the transistor will be in saturation mode. So, but you said that you didn't say that in LVC equals to zero, you say that LVC equal any value less than 0.7. In this equation, if I set if I set ال VCE, sorry, if I set ال VCE to be any value between 0 and 0.7, this equation will be the same. ال VCB will equal to negative 0.7, negative any value negative. So still ال VC will be, ال VB will be greater than ال VC. Okay. If you مثلا say, set ال VCE equal 0.2. So you will put in this equation in ال 0.2 minus 0.7, it will be negative value. It will be negative 0.5. So ال VCB will equal to negative value and so on. If you said if you put any value less than 0.7, the equation will be the same. ال VCB will equals to negative value. But if you set ال VCE equal to say 0.8, so 0.8 minus 0.7 will be 0.1, which is a positive value. So the junction will be reverse and the transistor will still in the active mode. Okay, so the output characteristic curve give us a possible range of values that inform me at which values the transistor will be in active mode and at which set of values the transistor will be in saturation mode. Okay. Why I would like to مثلا study these values, if I will make a circuit for a transistor to be in amplifier, to work as an amplifier, to amplify the input circuit, amplify the input voice, amplify, sorry, the input signal, amplify the input voice. So I would like to make sure that my microphone is still works as an amplifier. So I would like to make sure that in the range of values of the IC and the VCE and so on will be in the logical range of values in of the amplifier. Okay. Okay. So this is the characteristic curve of the BGT out characteristic curve of the transistor. We have output characteristic curve and input characteristic curve since we have two loops or we have two junctions. Right. A transistor can be used as an amplifier, as we said before, and can be used as a switch, switch off or switch on. The transistor also can be used as can be used in building logic gates. Okay, so this is the circuit of a transistor to be in as an amplifier. You have to build a transistor, two transistor connected together, where resistor by this shape. So you will have an output at this point, and this is the input voice. This will be the output amplified signal. Or voice. طيب this is what I mean by amplification. If I have a signal like this sine wave, I will have output output يعني value amplified than it. Okay. طيب this is the idea of a switch on, switch off. Switch off means that the transistor acts as an open circuit. It doesn't exist in the circuit. But the switch on, this means that the transistor works as a short circuit. So it works as a connected line between the two endpoints. Okay. This idea can be used as in logic gates. If I would like to build the NOT gate, this is a truth table of a NOT gate. If you have a zero, the result will be one, and if you have one, the result will be zero. This is the symbolic notation, or a equal a negative, or this if you have a here, you will have a negative a here, or a bar here. To build this circuit, we will use only one transistor and the resistor connected series together, but we will measure the V out or a bar at this point. If we would like to trace the Vn, if we set the Vn to be zero, so this means that this is an open circuit, which means that I have here a resistor and a broken line between the two points, and this V out is connected to, is not connected to this end, it will be connected to this end, which is the VCC. So it will equal to 5 or will equal to 1, يعني a signal يعني, not 0. But if we bought VN to be 1, the transistor will work as a short circuit, okay? So the V out will connect it to the ground. So the V out will equal to 0, okay? طيب. I think we have to trace this to مثلا make it clear. We have two possible cases. If we set LVN equal to 0, or we set LVN equal to 1. If we set LVN equal to 0, this circuit will be something like this. The transistor will be an open circuit. If we set LV out to be كذا, it will be short circuit. So it will be كذا. Okay, with the ground. This will be the LV out, where this is the V source or VCC, which has a value, and this is the VCC, which has a value, and this is the V out, and this is the ground. At this case, lower lemma LVN, LVN is so zero, LVN is so zero, LV out is not connected to the ground, is not connected to the ground since we have open circuit. The V out will equal to, will connect it to the VCC or the V source. Okay, so it will have the value of the VCC. It will be equal to 1, equal to 0, any value. So the V out will equal to 1 or 5 in this case. Okay, طيب. If the VCC equal to 5 and ال V1, ال V input. الـ V input equal to 0 وهير الـ V input equal to 1 الـ V out is connected to the ground. Okay, so الـ V out will be the same point, so الـ V out will equal to 0. Okay, it will be 0. V out equal 0. So this is the circuit of a NOT gate. If you have A here, you will have A bar here. والA is the VN والA bar is the VO. Okay. And so on for any other gate. If you have the AND gate to simulate the AND gate, this is the truth table of the AND gate. We will use two transistor and a resistor. two transistor and a resistor is connected to in series together. If the VN, if the VN is 0 and the VN is 0, so this is an open circuit. This open circuit, the V out will not be connected to the VC, it will be connected to the ground, so the V out will equal to 0. If we set 0, 1, يعني 0 here and 1 here, so it will be open circuit and will be short circuit, the V out will connect to the V out, and vice versa of if 1 and 0. this will be a short circuit and this will be open circuit. So LV out will connect to zero, but if LV in will V in equal to 1, so it will be short circuit connected wire between this point and this point, so LV out will equal to 5, which is 1. If you set LVCC to be 1, so it will be LV out will be 1. Okay, so to build the AND gate, we can use 2 transistor and 1 resistor in series together. We can build a NAND gate, which is AND, not AND. We build the AND, then we build a NOT gate. So we'll have okay. We'll have transistor and resistor. We'll have resistor and transistor. Okay, this is the AND, not AND gate. We can check it by setting sorry, I think this is AND. This is 1, okay, 1. Since a not AND means that inverting the AND, which is 0, 0, 0, 1, it will be 1, 1, 1, 0. So we can use 2 transistor and resistor to build the NOT gate. If we set a 0 and 0, this means that open circuit and open circuit, so LV out will be connected to VCC, so it will be 1. If we set anyone to be 0, 0, and 1, it will be open circuit and it will be short circuit, so it will be out will connect it to VC. If we set both of them to be 1, this means that LV out will be connected directly to LV ground, since this is short circuit and this is short circuit, so LV out will equal to 0. And so on for the remaining circuits, which is R gate and OR gate with NOR gate, and so on for XOR. Okay, time. Till the moment we explain the characteristic curve of transistor, we explain the transistor for building logic gates. We will study that we have three main connections of a transistor that are very common. If I have a transistor in the circuit like this. Okay, we have a resistor in the base, resistor in the collector, and we need to have a resistor in the emitter. And we'd like to apply the KVL in this circuit. We will have a minus VBB plus I base R base plus VBE equals 0. Minus VBB plus IB RB plus VBE equals 0. If I would like to get the I base in our inside, so I base will equal to VBB minus VBE over R base. Okay. طيب يعني why I get an I base in a term يعني in a side alone, since as I said the characteristic curve, if I would like to apply the KVL in this loop, I would like to build the characteristic curve of that draw relationship between the I base and the VBE, so I will have to find the value of the I base alone, so the I base equal VB minus VB over the R base. طيب if I would like to apply the KVL in the second loop, it will be if we go anti-clockwise, so in minus VCC plus ICRC plus VCE equals 0. Minus VCC plus ICRC plus VCE equals 0. Okay. If I would like to get the VCE in a term alone, so VCE equal VCC minus ICRC. VCE equal VCC minus RC ICRC. Here is the relation that give us help us in the characteristic curve LVCB equal VCE minus VBE. طيب if I have a question like this and it asks to get the value of the IBS will IC will VCE will VBE will VBE and all any values of the current and all values of the volt. I have this circuit. I would like to redraw this circuit to be two loops together. Okay. So it will be a transistor. NPN transistor. And we have a resistor here. And a resistor here. And we have a resistor and battery and a resistor. الريزيستور فاليو في الار سي ايكوال 2.2 والريزيستور فاليو في الار بيز ايكوال 2.249 اوكي. والفي سي سي في سي سي مين ذات التو باتريز ايكوال ذا سيم فاليو 12 اند 12 اوكي. اي ثينك وي دونت هاف اني اذر فاليوز. طيب طيب البيتا ايكوال تو 50. It asks to get the value of the IBase. So as far as I know, according to this this configuration, I have in IBase equal VBE VCC minus VBE over RBase. I know the value of the VCC and I know the value of the VBE and I know the value of the RBase. So it will be this value. To get the value of IC, I know that in the IC equal beta IB. So 50 multiplied by this value, it will be this number. To get the VCE, it will it is the VCC minus the ICRC. I know the value of the IC and the RC and the VCC. I can get the value of the VCE, which is 6.883. According to this equation, the VE is connected to the ground, so the V equal to zero, and I know that in the VB equal to 0.7, so the VB equal to 0.7. يعني the VBE equal 0.7. وال VE equal 0 so ال VB equal 0.7. To get the value of ال VCE and we know that in ال VE equal 0 so ال VC equal this value. It will be the same value of ال VCE since the VE equal 0. We would like to make sure that this transistor is in active mode, so compare the values of ال VB ال V ال VB less than ال VC or not. So ال VC is 6.8 okay, وال VB equal 0.7, so 0.7 is less than 0.7 is less than 0.7 is less than no no I mean that in ال ثواني to be in active mode ال VB should be less than 0.7. I think this means that in ال VC is greater than VBC, VB minus ال VC equal 0.7 minus ال 6, it will be negative value. So ال VBC, ال VBC negative value, so ال VB is greater than. Okay, طيب. Okay. This is this configuration in which we have only one resistor at the base and one resistor at the collector called fixed bias configuration. Fixed bias configuration. Okay. Right. If we have another configuration in which we have a resistor at the emitter. If we have a configuration like this, like the previous configuration, but we have an resistor at the emitter. The difference is that we have a resistor at the emitter. We can add, we have RC, R base, and RE. RE in this A, in this position. So this configuration is called emitter bias. Emitter bias configuration, in which is in which we have RE. To apply the KVL in this loop and apply KVL in this loop, we may have these two equations. In this loop, we will have minus VCC plus IBRB plus VBE plus IERE equals zero. We have to add all voltages at this loop, voltage 1, 2, 3, 4. Minus VCC, if we go clockwise, minus VCC plus IBRB plus VBE plus IERE equals zero. to get the relation to get the equation to be in terms of IB only, we know that in IE equal ان الاي اي ايكوال الاي سي بلس الاي بي الاي سي بلس الاي بي والاي سي ايكوالز بيتا اي بي ايكوال بيتا اي بي. if we get الاي بيز to be a common factor, so الاي بيز الاي اي will equal to بيتا بلس 1 I base, okay? الاي اي will equal, so we have to replace الاي اي from this equation to be بيتا بلس 1 I base. This equation will be VCC minus VBE minus I. If we'd like to get the I base in a term alone, it will be VCC minus VBE over R base plus beta plus 1 RE, okay? طيب. We'll add only this term, the IRE, and replace it to be in terms of I base, so it will be beta plus 1 I base. For the second loop, if we'd like to apply KVL clockwise or anti-clockwise, it will be minus, it will be minus VCC plus ICRC plus VCE plus IERE equals 0. Okay? If you multiply this equation by negative 1, it will be IERE plus VCE plus ICRC minus VCC equals 0. I think it's the same equation. You have to apply KVL in a clockwise or anti-clockwise. ماشي؟ minus VCC minus VCC plus ICRC plus ICRC plus VCE plus VCE plus IRE. Okay. To get IE. To get IE, VCE, sorry, in a term alone, it will be equals to VCC minus IC multiplied by RC RE. In this equation, we have IC and IE. We can replace IC, IE by IC, since generally IE equal IC, since general I base will be less, يعني smaller value, So VC equal, this equation can be again be ICRE plus VCE plus ICRC plus minus VC equal zero. To get the IC as a common factor, we will have the IC multiplied by the RE and RC. To get the VCE alone, the VCE equal VCC minus IC, IC multiplied by RC plus RE. To solve a question about it, we have this figure. We can replace this figure to be, I hope to, مثلا, ماشي. يعني, I prefer to draw it as a closed loop. Okay. So according to the previous BCC equal 20 and 20, okay, 20 and 20, 2 and 1, okay, so I will have 20 and 20 and 2 and 1. Okay, I think the value of the R base is 430. طيب, if it asks to about the I base, so the I base equal to the VCC minus the VBE over the R base plus beta plus 1 RE, we know all the values, so we can get the 20 minus the 0.7 over ال 430 plus 51 multiplied by 1. That will be this value of ال I base. We can get ال IC, ال IC equal beta IB, we can get ال IC. To get ال VCE, ال VCE according to this equation, ال VCE equal VCC minus ICRC plus RE, we know all the values of ال R and ال IC and ال VCC, so we can get ال VCE. طيب to get the value في ال VC ال VC equal ال VCC minus RC minus ICRC ال current ال current at this branch current at this branch okay ال current at this point ال V input minus ال V out over ال R so ال VCC ال 20 minus ال VC equal ال current over ال R sorry over ال R اللي هو over 2 equal current اللي هو IC مين ال VO؟ ال VO is ال VC if I know the value of IC I can get the value of ال VC so ال VC equal VCC I would like to get ال VCC alone it will be ICRC VCC minus ال ICRC it will be this value if we'd like to compare the values, it will be in the active mode. El VC is greater than el VB. Okay, I think it doesn't require el VB. But we can get, yeah, get it. Type. Oh, okay. Type. Then I said before we have three common configurations of transistor being active mode. The fixed bias in which we have RC and R base. The limiter bias in which we have RC, R base and RE. And the third configuration is the voltage divider bias in which we have RC and RE and two resistor at the base. Okay. So we have RE, R base 1, R base 2. If we'd like to complete this circuit, we'll have a resistor at the RC. So to try to solve this circuit, well, first of all, we can get the equivalent circuit of this A, of this part, which is the R7N and V7N. To get the R7N, we assume that we have the AA. مثلا here we assume that we have ال A and ال B ال A and ال B ال A and ال B and get the equivalent ال R1 will be parallel with ال R2 so ال R7 equal to ال R1 parallel مع R2 أو ال equal to ال R1 multiplied by ال R2 over ال R1 plus R2 Okay, so the main difference between the voltage divider and the other configuration is that we have two resistors at the base, and we can solve this, and we'd like to replace this circuit to be only one resistor and one voltage to be like the emitter bias, R base, RE, and RC. So we have to replace this circuit by its equivalent circuit, which is the 7 circuit. To find the 7 circuit, we have to get the R7 and the V7. To get the R7N, we make the open the A will be and as a short circuit and find the R7 equal to the R equivalent of this circuit, will R7 equal R1 and R2 are parallel together. To get the value of the V7N. To get the value of the V7N, we have to make the A will be open circuit and okay. We have to make the A will be open circuit and V7N is the same. The V7N is the same as the VR2. Okay, so the A. B open circuit will V7N is the V between A will B will A is this point will B is this point since it is an open circuit so V7N equal to VR2 to find the value of this V7N equal VR2 it will be VCC multiplied by R2 over R1 plus R2 so we have to solve this equation or find this equation to replace this circuit by something like this ال R7 and ال E7 and continue the circuit. Okay, it will be something like this. Okay, so we'll have RC, we'll have RE, and we'll have R7 instead of the R1 and R2. We'll have V7 instead of VCC. To apply the KVL in this loop, we'll find the I base equal to E7 minus the VBE over R7 plus beta plus 1 RE. It will be the same equation as the emitter bias, except that in every VCC is blessed by E7, every R base is blessed by R7. To apply the KVL in the second loop, we will have the same equation as the emitter bias, since there is no difference. We have RC and RE, and VCC and VCE. So VC equal VCC minus IC plus multiplied by RC plus RE. Okay. If we have a question about the voltage divider, I think it's the same. يعني we have to find the R7 first, then we have to find the V7. Then find the value of the I base. Then find the value of the IC and so on. Okay. طيب. This all for a transistor. We have to know what are the transistor, which transistor, the main component of transistor, the main applications, the main types, the main configurations. How the transistor can work as an amplifier. The main conditions of transistor being amplifier, which is consider the size, consider the doping, consider the configuration or the connection. As you have to study the main characteristic curve of a transistor, what are the values or range of values at which a transistor can work in a saturation, can work in the cutoff, or work in the active mode. We have the transistor can work is in the logic gates. And what are the main configurations of a transistor to be in active mode, a fixed bias, emitter bias, voltage divider? Generally, a voltage divider is better than other configuration, since it makes sure that the transistor doesn't depend on the parameter, which is called beta. Beta is the parameter that depends on the temperature of the circuit. So if we have الاي بيز ان الكوليكتور الاي بيز ان ذا فيكسد بايس تو بي ان ايكويشن اند الاي سي ايكوال بيتا اي بي. اوكي وي وود لايك تو ميك الاي سي تو بي دازنت ديبند اون البيتا. سو الاي بيز ايكويشن شود هاف البيتا ان اتس نيوميريتور ان اوردر تو ريموف ات together. So we would like to make a configuration in which the I base has a beta in its denominator. So in fixed bias, we didn't have any beta. In emitter bias, we have the I base equal R base plus beta plus 1 RE. So we can remove this beta, and we have here مثلا if الIC equal beta multiplied by LI base, which is this equation. Okay, we can replace this by this, but we cannot make this purely since we have R base here. So we'd like to make R base as smaller as possible to in order to neglect it in the equation. The configuration that makes this by perfect method, perfect way is the transistor is the voltage divider in which IC IC equal beta. We have numerator here, but we have here R7, which in general R7 is less than R base, since R7 is a result of the equivalent resistor between two parallel resistors, which is generally less than الاتس ايه اونلي وان ريجستر. سو اف ذس الار 7 اس از ليس ذان الار بيز، سو وي كان نيجلكت ات اند ميك الاي بيز از ريموفد باي الار سوري البيتا از ريموفد باي البيتا and then from the numerator to the numerator and then the IC will not depend on the beta anymore and we have stable stable configuration that make sure that that transistor is in active mode where the beta is the temperature of the room doesn't make sense that we have an amplifier that if the temperature of the room is increased so it doesn't work so we have to make a configuration that doesn't depend on the temperature of the room. Okay. This is all for this lecture. Hope we meet in any other lecture. Okay, see you.